I find not this to be, this is not in order, in my opinion, because for you to do any recording, there needs to, you need to have communicated that that there will be recording. So, for example, if you enter any building that has CCTV, it's under obligation to show that there is, you know, CCTV surveillance or such a thing. So any person who is being recorded need to be aware that is happening or is going to be happening at some point. Now, these are customers or shoppers who are not aware they are being recorded. And then from this case, it doesn't seem like it is CCTV that are mounted on the at the shop or the outlet. So I think this doesn't seem to be in order. With regard to mystery shopping, and I think this caught my interest, is there is a lot of mystery shopping that we do where you get to do recording. But because if I tell the person who is recording at that point that, hey, I am recording you, then of course they're going to be in their best behavior and everything like that. But then if it is a bank, for example, then the bank will let their staff know that this exercise is going to be happening. And for 1, 2, 3 objectives, we are going to be having a recording. And it is then only after the bank has that communication or communicates to their staff that is going to be happening, that then the exercise is supposed to happen. That is entirely my view. I would like to hear feedback. But in this particular case that's given on the slide, I don't think it is right.
I don't clearly know how GDPR is impacted.
Paul, you were going in and out. We didn't quite hear what you were saying.
Sorry, I was saying I don't know how GDPR has impacted mystery shopping. So if there's anyone who, you know, has more clarity on that side, probably could tell us how it reflects, how it protects the respondents, as well as the practice itself. Because if it is still required for market research, then means we have to find a balance between the privacy for the individual, as well as having a way for us to carry out without infringing the rights. Was I audible? Nganga, did you?
No, I can hear you very well, but I'm not of much help. I'm waiting to hear just like you.
Okay, thanks. Althea, did you have something to say?
Sorry, I was actually just trying to look at some of the data protection slides that we had produced at some time. I think basically, as it stands, it's certainly not something that is ethical. However, again, if you think about the data protection, perhaps it may well be that it's permissible to record, and somebody can certainly pick me up on this, but certainly you would not be able to use or to show faces or any indications as to who the people are. And I guess that might also be the case as well for voices and the likes, and that's certainly without their permission.
Thanks,
Althea.
Anyone else with a view?
Okay, then we can return the meeting back to Emily.
Okay, thank you so much. This is Susan. And thank you, Althea, Higa, for all your contributions. At this point, as I want to run the program a bit faster, I think production of the program is just a recap or a brief on the discipline, MSRA ethics disciplinary procedures. I think Paul will manage it a very short time, less than 5 minutes, if you can. Yes.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you again, everyone, for staying with us. We're going to be a few minutes late. We did not intend to violate your ethical commitment. This program, which was supposed to end at 3:30, so we're requesting your patience. Stay on the call. Stay on the call, then you'll be able to catch up the recording later. So basically, I think as Nganga has taken us through the process, I must admit that it's very difficult to speak after Nganga, because it's a very exciting session. But for our side, I think it's basically how we handle issues of breach of ethics. So I think first I would state that ethics is a journey. It's not something you transform in a single day. You don't wake up the following day and you're a different person. There's still that struggle in your mind as you try to change to get through what you deem to be unethical behavior. So don't feel bad or discouraged when you realize that you have some ethical struggles. So we have a process for handling breach of ethics, and this applies to both individual as well as to the agencies themselves. Both those who are members of MSRA and those who are not members of MSRA. As time will not allow me to go through the entire process, I will just highlight that as cases come up, our commitment is that we work with our members to try and correct what may have been found to be unethical behavior. So our primary objective is not to punish our members. It is to have a corrective process whereby we work together with the members, whether it's an agency or an individual, to get back on the track of the ethical behavior or ethical expectations. So even though we have a disciplinary process to address breach, the main aim is not to get members out of our association or out of the industry for that matter. It is more to get the industry and everyone in the industry working to the goal that we can have a reset practice that can be respected by all stakeholders, both in our clients, our fellow researchers, as well as the government bodies. We know that this is a challenge, of course, having the government give us due consideration in what we do. We have seen what happens in political opinions or such researches. And what we would try to avoid is a situation where we create mistrust with our stakeholders. So our main aim for the disciplinary process is actually not to punish members who fall off the process of the ethics. So we outline the process. So what happens is if you suspect there is a breach of ethics, you as an individual or as an agency can raise a complaint. We have an ethics complaint form on MSRA website where you can fill in your details. You can state your name or agency's name, state the suspected breach of ethics, and submit that form. Now, to avoid a situation where we have errant people who just try to soil the name of other agencies or people, there is a fee when you are raising the ethical case. So it's a fee of 10,000 for an agency, and I think a fee of 3,000 for an individual. So you raise that, you submit that fee, your case will be heard, both parties will be given a hearing, and then on completion of the hearing, a decision will be made. If you are successful in the case approached, then you are refunded the fee. If you are not successful, then you forfeit the fee. Now, there will be different measures taken depending on the outcome of the case. the most mild one, of course.
We are meeting tomorrow.
Intended one is agreeing with the party. Yes. That you can correct the situation. But then the most extreme one, like we said in one of the consequences of breach of ethics earlier, is being expelled or suspended from which then, you know, may have a rather harsh consequences, which one is intended. But it is our hope that, you know, in all cases...
Then we will meet... We will meet without you, since obviously it's too late to, you can't stop a meeting, hours to the meeting. People will not take you seriously. So you may not come because we want your job protection, but we will meet on our own and make a decision. Because obviously you can't, if you were stopping, you should have stopped it earlier in the week, at the beginning of the week. Because now you know people have cancelled their trips, they have cancelled their everything in order to be there. Now even if you say the meeting is not there and they had cancelled other things, they will feel very, their life has been interfered with. And since we don't, you normally don't give us allowance in every meeting. No, remember we are only paid a number of times per year. Yeah, so this may be the fourth meeting.
5 minutes or less.
Remember, you told us from the beginning that we are not limited to 3 times. We can meet more times, but you can only pay us 3 times. So you could also come and you don't pay us. Yeah. My suggestion is you come to the meeting, but we know you don't have any payment. Thank you. Yeah, we are meeting physically. That's what the Wazirs told me. They were not very happy with the Zoom.
What are the steps taken to save the situation, especially for pollsters?
So that's where we are meeting. All Saints, the same All Saints outside there. There is enough air. Okay, then, okay, Asante.
Thank you. So basically, what happens is if there are queries which are raised, and if they are not ideally for us, for the ethics committee, a formal complaint is only addressed. A complaint is addressed when it is formally raised through the formal process. And yes, you know, there were people who reached out to
MSA,
and we requested them. Ndede
wira ndomatia kenirio ne Zoom kogo majirite munyoro ni ahurire githu ni arahunjireire ajira gikorwa ni maracha mania kanithari ithio tura gucha mania tu hena excuse yireko
because we are not able to hear from the person who is in the complaint. It means that we are unlikely to get to a fair
complaint. No, I sent a message several in a group. If you load your WhatsApp, you will see I stated the meeting of Friday. This is not the first time.
Thank you. I hope the first that is for you, so it just stresses on the need for us to raise.
I never said it's physical.
You can raise your hand or unmute to speak because you are running out of time.
Okay, reuli mwe bukuru boto inagaru eza wo demo hiyo na wanyona. Riwega ni wethikira meya. To in my mind, to twariana ye doi, to kiariana donieta daria na adu othe. That's my mistake and I apologize.
The situation has a reputation.
Margaret, of course, will ring. She can't come physically. But you ring the normal way, yes.
Because if we are waiting for someone to just register the complaint, and then the reputation damage has happened, whether perceived or reality.
Arajira ati ni dagetete approval for the allowances. Don't worry. According to the rules, we are supposed to meet 4 times, quarterly. No, the fourth one to three ago. You call this one, the one we are not paid.
But you also want to protect
the interest
or rather
it was to Germany for a long time.
So,
and we need to make a decision as to how to progress. We can to Tigana to Hanatari, that we are the Akoreho. No, Bible, Harayogati, Jesus, the Muridua Koreho. Muridua Koreho, Atiga Vera to Darareho.
The complainant, as well as
we cannot fail to meet at Todara. Dara, 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 dara.
But does that respond to your query?
Up to now that they're having approval. That he has a new leadership and they are being slow. Yeah. It's not like he's going to go in the week. He was still hoping to approve. But up to now, a few minutes ago, it has not been approved.
Okay. The hand here.
Yeah.
Right. At this point, we are nearing our closure. But
at a later time.
Following the training, we normally have as we've been informed throughout the session, that you normally have.
Agency that has participated in the list of
all their participants for this session. And then we have a standard letter that we share with all the agencies. So the standard letter is an emissary ethics committee.
Of course, 10 o'clock to the other to our year to our
argue. And share with us.
Basically, we'll call Margaret towards 11 o'clock. As usual.
They run every 2 years. So we will issue to every agency that regarding the individual participants in this session, we will share certificates of attendance for this for the MSRA ethics training. So that's basically what we'll prepare after this. That's why it's important for us to get the list of attendees from everybody who's in the session. Thank you. Back to you, Susan.
Yeah, thank you so much, Sylvia. And so at this point, really, my duty is just to thank you so much for, attending. I just want to note we had over 144 participants. Okay, it's dropped to 111, which is understandable. But I want to thank you for your patience for the session, for registering, for participating, for taking your time. We really do appreciate it as an SRA. Secondly, I want to really thank the organizers of this training.
Ati tutikaheo bia nikio okuja na hinyo gu damu tutithiaga tutire ari thia bia na tutekoyo bia na tuchamanagia.
Ni damu
iro gu ati muchamanio ri oku.
Have a good day. Want to thank in a special way the secretariat Sylvia and her team also who has done a good job in trying to sending out the invites, organizing this forum so that it is successful. So we thank you so much for your effort. And to Mr. John Nyanga, our trainer, I felt like I was going back to school. I really felt I gained a lot. To put it in a simple and fun way that I understood. I hope it was the same for everybody else. We really thank you for your time and for sharing your knowledge with us. I think we'll come to the end of this session, and we want to thank everybody. If that is all, we can say, the meeting comes to an end, and we wish you the best. Thank you so much for
listening. Just a minute. Request. We've received requests from agencies that we share the recording, so that we'd like to notify everyone that we'll be making.
You're dropping off, Paul. We can't hear you.
Oh, Sylvia.
Yes, you're okay now.
Okay. So I was saying that we've received requests from agencies that we share the recording with them so that they can use it for their internal training. So I wanted us to just to notify everyone that we'll be making the recording for this session available to the agencies.
Okay. Thank you so much, Paul. If there's nothing else, then we wish everybody the best. I think we are free to leave.